I thought Northwestern State was a very good basketball team, very well coached. We could tell we hadn't played in about 2 weeks. We missed a lot of easy shots, and our defense wasn't a priority. But I think the second half we got our point across and got the ball inside and showed a little bit of glimpse of what our defense is supposed to be like.
Take questions now for the student athletes. Go here and then here.
Andrea, could you talk about what it was like to defend a point guard who the coach admits is only 4'11", not 5'2"? She's so low and she's so quick and could help also. Well, what was that like in playing against anybody?
Oh, she was a great point guard. She was super crafty with the ball. She was quick. She had good change of direction moves and really good footwork. And it was a challenge, especially for some of our taller guards, to get low and stay in front of her and keep her in front of them. And she could score different ways. She had floaters. She had different moves. So it was a challenge. And we'll see good point guards along the way. So it was good.
Steve.
Lucy, y'all were up 11-2, like 5 of your first 6 shots. What happened back from that point on the rest of the first half? Was there kind of a false sense of security from that early lead, or what do you think the
I think we went away from our defensive assignments, and we might have gotten a little comfortable. But that just shows from not playing for 2 weeks, and we just got to get back in that rhythm of having a sense of urgency for the full 40 minutes.
Any other questions for the student athletes? We'll go in the back and then in the front.
Not exactly. I mean, Holly and Coach Elzy specifically were definitely frustrated with us, and we were frustrated with ourselves. So really, we came in, and a lot of us were saying things to each other. I mean, we weren't being negative or tearing each other down, but we just knew that we had to do better. And we, talked about what we needed to do, and basically everything surrounded just playing Lady Vol basketball and playing hard and giving our full effort on defense and playing together. And we all knew that's what we had to do. We were all on the exact same page, and we just came together.
They police themselves a lot of times. So,
Steve.
I think you scored 6 points in that 12-0 run that kind of turned the game around. Did you kind of take the home free kind of think you needed to take upon yourself to kind of take things over the high advantage
that had? I definitely wanted to establish a presence in the inside early in. I guess I decided to get into the feel of it, and I knew that people were looking towards me to get that offensive energy going, so I just took it upon myself to do it. But also, I think it helped a lot our defensive side as well, and it got us going, and everybody was talking to each other and correcting one another, and when we do that, you see a whole another different team.
All right, here and then here.
Andrea, they have kind of they're trying to get their unorthodox offense, but it seemed like their zone defense gave you guys trouble in the first half. You faced every defense in the world, I assume, over the course of the year. Why did they cause problems for you guys?
I think it was more just us. We've been out of it. We haven't played for 2 weeks and just been going against each other. And we were just a little out of rhythm, a little out of sync, and we forced a lot of shots instead of getting into the inside. So I think we lost ourselves just a little bit in that first half and really needed to just come together and play together as a team the way we did during the SEC tournament. So I think it was more us. I mean, they played really hard, and hats off to them. And they had a great game plan, and they made us force some shots. But once we got in a rhythm and started playing together, it was better.
Take a last one right here.
So either of the two players, it seems at the second half, Holly was a lot more animated, standing came on pretty early in the second half. The difference in her energy in the first half to the second half, how much did y'all kind of feed upon that, or did you even notice?
I definitely noticed, And Holly gets to stomping and yelling and draws your attention, and that's just her care for us and care for this game, her passion for the game, and she's trying to put it into us. So I think it helped when I see her on the sideline. And if we had any confusion, we look towards her, and she lets us know. So I think we really fed off of that.
All right, ladies, thank you very much. We'll dismiss the student athletes back to the locker room for the remainder of the open locker room period.
Yeah, I got you, Izzy. Thank you. Thanks for your vote of confidence.
We'll now take questions for Tennessee head coach Holly Warlick. John.
Holly, could you talk about your physical Why you tried to do more in the second half?
Well, I was a little under the weather last night. I got a bug, and I didn't probably this started probably this morning at 2, and about 9 this morning, I didn't think I was coming to the game. And I got a lot of IVs and fluids pumped in me, and that was my choice to sit the first half. I just was still a little lightheaded, and then I couldn't sit there any longer. And we went back in at halftime and tried to do IVs, and that was not even my focus. So we took the IV out I had, it's just difficult. I think when you have someone who's up and you have a voice, and then I'm not up and coaching the basketball team. And Kyra did a great job. You're not going to do too many good things when you shoot 22% the first half. And we were quick shooting the basketball. So I just felt I needed to get up, and somehow I found a lot of energy after the first half. Got a lot of energy and decided I need to get up and coach this basketball team.
But you had an IV. What was your last?
At halftime. Yeah.
Steve.
Yes. Yes. I had 2 this morning, and probably about 2 or 3 drops at halftime because I couldn't wait any longer, so I took it out. Well, when I got, I'd be honest with you. I didn't feel very well at all. And I hope I'm a pretty tough person, but but when they came in and gave me the IVs, it kind of gave me I quit being nauseated and dizzy, and hopefully they put some good stuff in there. I don't know what they put in there, but it worked. And I don't know how I'll be tonight, but I might have to get some of that stuff pumped back in. I don't know. So,
do you know what caused? Is it just a bug or food poisoning? Do you know what caused?
I think they thought it was food poisoning. We'll go with food poisoning. It's either a food poisoning or a bug. I did not. I stayed at home. I should have probably, but I did not. I'm not a very good hospital person. So
when you came here, where did you go?
They came to my house. Okay. Yeah, came to my house. I guess they did. Well, my doctor, I called her at 3 this morning, and then she came over when she, I guess, got up finally. And I had 3 people there, and they were just outstanding. I couldn't have obviously done it without them, but and our kids knew. I called, and our kids, they had a great shoot around, and they had a great prep. And I don't think that had anything to do with our slow start. I just think we hadn't played in 2 weeks, and we were playing against a great basketball team, a team I think they run the Princeton offense. They run it very well. They hit big shots. So I just think we had to get a game under our belt, and I'm sure it's probably difficult. I'm not standing up and coaching the team, and I'm sure that was difficult. That was hard. It was hard for me to sit there, but they figured out a way to. We shot 58% the second half and 94% from the free throw line. So you're not going to do too many good things. We were missing layups and putbacks, and so we said to get the ball inside, and we were quick shooting the basketball. And when you do that, you let teams hang around you, and that's what we did.
We'll take 2 more here and there.
Yeah, Holly, does this remind you, I know it only lasted a half, but before the way the second, but does it remind you just how fragile you can be in an NCAA tournament and things?
Oh, absolutely. you know, John, any team that takes for granted that we're seeded number one, and that's great for us. But the teams that get in this, Northwestern had to do something, State, do something great to get in this tournament. And you can't take anything lightly. And I'll refer back to Ball State when we got beat by Ball State in the first round in Bowling Green. We cannot overlook anybody or take somebody for granted that we're gonna win. And we got off to a slow start, and I think we had a little bit of a jitters. But no, you can't. It's like any other team in any other tournament. This is it, and these teams are playing. They should play 40 minutes of their best basketball or all out, because it's there's no we got to get better tomorrow. This is it. So. Hopefully we got that out of our system, and then we can get back to playing a little bit, 40 minutes of basketball.
All right, final question over here.
What did you tell them at halftime? I mean, what was kind of their attitude? Was it a shell shock at halftime?
Like I said, they policed themselves, and they understood. We weren't playing any defense. We were quick shooting the basketball. They were not having to defend at all. And we missed easy baskets, and we're a team that kind of when things are we kind of it snowballs. If we miss, then it seems like Megan missed, and then Bashar missed, and Izzy missed, and then we get on a roll, and then we get on a positive roll. So, but I probably was more upset with our defense and. You know, getting beat, not talking, not switching. We start off with a switching man. Wasn't very good. We went to a just straight up man-to-man. It was better. But we gave them too many open looks. We put them at the free throw line. You know, it just we fouled. And we got to be a little bit more disciplined. And we're bigger. We were bigger. We were stronger. But we that wasn't getting it done the first half.
All right, Coach, thank you very much.
All right, thank you all.